This is a 160 Q&A practice test. Plaintiff attorney, Mr. Stone, capital S-T-O-N-E. Defense attorney, Ms. M-S period Davis, capital D-A-V-I-S. And we'll start with the plaintiff. Ready? What did you do for them? I supervised the maintenance of locomotives. Same job, basically. Same. Western bought out the contract, so I went from Nelson Power to Western. How long were you working for Nelson Power? 7 years. So it was basically the same job duties? Yes. And you would occasionally drive a forklift? Yes. How about before Nelson Power? I worked for Santa Fe as a mechanic for 25 years. I was kind of hoping you'd have a 25 year in there so I wouldn't go through too many more. And basically doing mechanical work on locomotives? Correct. Would you operate forklifts about the same intervals that you would during your employment with Western and Nelson Power? Maybe a little more. Where did you first receive training on operating a forklift? From Santa Fe. My first training was in 72, which that was my first job. I actually started as a laborer and worked, drove forklift and that type of thing. All right, describe the training you received in the operation of a forklift. We had classes and took tests, seen videos and actual driving of the forklift. On the job training. After your initial training to drive a forklift, did you receive periodic other training as your career went on? No. Did you receive any type of a certificate to operate a forklift as a result of your training? Yes. What was the certificate called? They just gave us a license. Who did? Santa Fe. Okay, when you started working for Colton Industrial Supply in April 2008, did they do any additional training of you in the operation of their forklifts? No. What were your job duties at Colton Industrial Supply? Well, let's say at or near the date of the accident on May 3, 2010. One more time, please. What were your job duties in 2010 working for Colton Industrial Supply? I'm basically a janitor, forklift operator. Well, basically that's it. Put away material and stuff as we unloaded and things of that nature. All right, what percentage of your job duties are spent operating the forklift for Colton Industrial Supply in 2010? Approximate once a day, unload a vehicle, a truck. Are there other employees of Colton Industrial Supply whose duties are to unload trucks when they deliver material to them? All the employees are capable and do on occasion unload trucks, whoever is available at the time. When you say all employees of Colton Industrial Supply are capable of operating a forklift, how many employees are we talking about? Let's see, four other than myself that are employed, even the manager, which would add up to five. He does sometimes operate the forklift. How many times per week on the average would you operate a forklift and unload trailers while you've been employed by Colton Industrial Supply? Since he started in 2008, we're not talking about a long period of time. Okay, all right, when I started, I basically did not do that type of work for the first, say, 3 years. I basically cleaned up the yard and it was in quite a mess at the time. And I spent a lot of time the first 3 years just cleaning and sweeping and disposing of a lot of old material and cleaning up the yard and making it a cleaner area. So that's what I did in the first couple years. As I got that done, they lost an employee, moved on, so I just sort of started cleaning inside the building and operating the forklift when necessary, unloading a truck. The last 2.5 years, I would say, I averaged maybe twice a week. And 9 times out of 10, that's unloading metal off the a delivery truck that brings us our metal or steel, which takes maybe 15 minutes a day. I might do that twice a week. All right, going back to the accident date, which I have as May 12, 2011, does that meet with your recollection of the date this incident occurred? Yes, it does. Okay, how long before that date had you gone back to operating forklifts? Oh, a good year anyway. I mean, on a regular basis. I used a forklift the total time I was there, on and off, but not for the first 2.5 years. It was basically around the yard, just moving things for my own convenience and whatever, not unloading the trucks and stuff until later, like I said, about 2.5 years into my employment there. And you went back to that because they lost an employee? Well, one of the employees left. I was working myself out of a job, basically. I got the yard all cleaned up, the warehouse cleaned up, and it needed to be done, so that was my job, basically. Okay, on May 12, 2011, were you a full-time employee of Colton Industrial Supply? No, I've never been a full-time employee. I work 3 days a week, part-time. 3 days, 8 hours a day. Yes. How many forklifts did Colton Industrial Supply own on May 12, 2011? One. Had that always been the case, that they just had one forklift the entire time you worked there since June of 2008? Yes. Could you describe that forklift for me? Do you know the manufacturer of the forklift? I can't think of it right now. I believe it's a 5-ton. Do you know if it had interchangeable forks? Yes, it did. All right, how many sets of forks did Colton Industrial, not interchangeable. They had one set of forks, and then they have extended forks that they could put on it. It went over the top of the original forks. Okay, so they had another set of forks to extend the forks, but they fit over, correct. So one set of forks was always on the forklift, correct? Yes, sir. Okay, the set of forks that were always on the forklift, how long were those forks? I'm going to estimate 4 feet. And when the extended forks were placed over the 4-foot forks, how long were they at full extension? Again, estimate 5.5 feet total. Okay, I want to take you to the day of the accident on May 12, 2011. When did you receive notification that on that date you were going to be unloading a truck that was coming in? When the truck arrived, which is around noon, I just automatically get on the forklift, go out, and unload it, where whoever is available would do the same. Excuse me. All right, we have the word list. We have Western, capital WESTERN. Nelson Power, capital NELSON. New word, capital POWER. Nelson Power. Santa Fe, capital SANTA. New word, capital FE, Santa Fe. Colton Industrial Supply, capital COLTON. New word, capital INDUSTRIAL. New word, capital SUPPLY. Colton Industrial Supply. Right, that will do it for the word list, and that will conclude our 160 Q&A practice test.